12 days. That is how long this legislation has existed, and we are already shoving it through on final passage. This bill should be solving a significant problem if we have such urgency, and yet it is not. Put simply, we should not even be discussing this. State legislation is not needed. Rules already exist that regulate how private individuals, collective groups like churches and nonprofit groups, including community bail funds, may post bail. Not only are there clear and adequate rules, but it was admitted in committee that this legislation is not tackling an actual problem. No justification whatsoever was provided other than vague theories of professionalism, which is an odd sticking point given that we have traditionally attempted to stake out a claim of being anti-regulation, and yet here we are calling for regulation where there is none needed. Though community bail funds are clearly the target of this ALEC-backed bail bond industry giveaway, this bill is not just about community bail funds. This legislation would limit the ability of churches to come together to support their congregation members, relatives to come together to support their family members, neighbors to come together to support neighbors. This would regulate into the ground for no clear purpose any and all attempts by individuals to come together and support their neighbors caught up in the legal system. One of the most astounding leaps of logic that I heard about this legislation is the fear-mongering around cartels, which is not only misguided practically and geographically, it also displays a shocking ignorance of how community bail funds, sophisticated criminal organizations, and our criminal legal system each operate. Community bail funds have existed since 1920, when similarly overreaching legislators created the Red Scare and prompted mass arrests. They are not and have never been linked to organized crime. Community bail funds do not receive donations from individuals or organizations to specifically bail out any single individual. They exist to support those who are unjustly trapped in unaffordable bail. Donations provided by shadowy organizations attempting to use bail funds as a front simply does not happen, and there is no evidence whatsoever that it does. In order to post bail a person, whether posting as an individual or on behalf of a bail fund or community group, has to present their state ID and provide contact information to the court. The funds are raised from tiny donations from community members and individuals near and far. Some donations are as low as $5, symbolic of the community banding together to support those in greatest need of assistance. In specific cases involving drug charges, the bail setting authority is able to use what is referred to as the Nebbia order, meaning that in order to post bail, the would-be poster has to appear before the judge to testify that the source of the funds to be used is not related to the crime for which the defendant is accused. If the judge lifts the order, only the person who appeared in court can post bail, and they must act as a surety for the bail posted. Community bail funds are different from bondsmen. They do not profit on the caging of our fellow community members. They do not depend on a system where those without the financial means to post bail themselves are forced to submit to surveillance and coercion prior to their day in court. Bail funds are a manifestation of communities rejecting the idea that caging people leads to community safety, and proof that our current system is unnecessary, cruel, and ineffective. Unlike bondsmen, community bail funds exist solely for the public benefit and do not charge for their services or exact repayment from the individuals and families that they serve. The individuals assisted by community bail funds are working class and low-income people, many of whom struggled to find and maintain safe housing or were unhoused prior to their incarceration. Requiring bail funds, churches, and other community groups who come together to post bail for our neighbors would only serve to chill this activity and limit the ability of poor and low-income people to make bail. Bail funds, churches, and community groups, unlike bondsmen, post bail for our neighbors without the requirement of payment. Registration and regulation of private citizens who post bail for their neighbors free of charge would not provide any benefit to the community and would, in fact, prove to be a burden. Pennsylvania already has the 9th highest rate of pretrial detention, with 270 people in jail for every 100,000 residents. Pretrial detainees, people who have not actually been convicted of the crime for which they are accused, make up more than 60% of our current jail population. A study that examined bail and court appearance rates in Pittsburgh and Philadelphia found no evidence that cash bail increased the probability of appearance for subsequent court dates. However, it did find that cash bail increases the likelihood of recidivism by 6 to 9%. After just 3 days in jail, people can lose their jobs, housing, custody of their children, and even their lives. Community bail funds help mitigate this harm by posting bail free of charge. Under the guise of professionalizing a system that has worked well for over 100 years, we are reinforcing a system that allows people with financial means to purchase their freedom while those without means remain incarcerated. Because pretrial detention is directly correlated with increases in defendants waiving fundamental rights like preliminary hearings and pleading guilty when they otherwise would not, this legislation would only exacerbate the disproportionate negative impact our criminal justice system already has on low-income communities and communities of color. This bill solves no stated problem, creates significant new ones, and leaves our criminal legal system somehow even more unjust than it already is. I cannot support it, and I cannot understand how any of my colleagues here would. I ask you to vote no. Thank you.